I will not be as creative as my previous speaker. So I'm presenting the paper by Babcock et al. On promotable and non-promotable tasks. And you have all heard about this, or you have all experienced this. So promotable tasks are tasks that help you to get promoted. Like, for example, in business, revenue-generating tasks are promotable tasks because it's easy to measure what you have done, and they help you to get promoted. Whereas in academia, for example, it's writing papers, presenting at conferences, and so on. What are non-promotable tasks? Non-promotable tasks is writing the minutes in a committee, or engaging in a reform of the curriculum. There is circumstantial evidence that women tend to go more into non-promotable tasks, and that might be a reason why they get less promoted. Now, circumstantial evidence is never fully convincing, therefore, what kind of evidence could we provide to make that more convincing? And what this paper does is, the authors develop an experiment in which they document very strong gender differences. And the experiment goes as follows. So these subjects come to the laboratory, and they are in groups of three. Every period they come together with a different people, again a group of three. And in each period they have to make one investment decision. So one person in the group has to make an investment decision. So if no investment decision is made, everybody in the group earns a dollar. If one individual makes an investment decision, then that individual earns $1.25, but the other two individuals earn $2. So you want to have the other people in the group making the investment decisions and not you. And so they have 2 minutes time to make that investment decision, and the question is, what happens? Now, what theory says is that people wait until the last second, and in the very last second, at least one of them makes that investment decision, okay? Now, when you do this experiment with gender mixed groups, so that the women know that there are men and the men know that there are women in the group, what happens? Across all of the 10 periods, we see a strong gender gap in investment. Women invest more than men. And actually, the gap is between 15 and 20 percentage points. So women invest more in non-promotable tasks, okay? Because the experiment captures exactly that non-promotability. I mean, think of writing the minutes in a meeting. Writing the minutes in the meeting, it's important that we have the minutes. Everybody benefits from having the minutes. But the guy or the person who has to write the minutes has the effort. Or being at a university with a good curriculum, everybody benefits from that. But one person or the few persons that are in that committee, they have the cost. So what we observe here is that women invest more in these non-promotable tasks. And now the question is why? Is it that women are more pro-social? Or is it that everybody believes that the women anyway will have a bigger tendency to do that? For example, if all men know that there is a woman in the group, and they all believe that the women will eventually do it, and the women will also believe that in the end the men have a lower probability to do it, it's rational for the women to do it. Okay? Now, how can you test this? Well, you make single-sex groups, and everybody knows it's a single-sex group. What happens in a single-sex group? Are women still more willing to invest? No. It completely goes away when women are in a single-sex group, and when women are in a single-sex group, and when men are in a single-sex group, there's no difference in investments. It's only when they know that they are in mixed-sex groups that women invest more in these non-promotable tasks. And now the final piece of evidence is, what happens if there is a fourth person added to the group, and that person can request somebody to do the task? And that requester knows the gender composition. Thus the requester, whether it's female, whether it's a man or a woman, is the person more likely to ask a woman? The answer is yes. So basically, requesters ask more that women do the non-promotable tasks, and women, not because of an intrinsic pro-sociality, but because of a prevailing belief, tend to invest more in non-promotable tasks. And they do many other analyses that back up this result. It has nothing to do with intrinsic taste for these tasks. It's really the fact that there are these beliefs in society, and we would need some belief intervention to basically remedy the problem. Thank you.